Hello friends, welcome to the Cool Vedas, that's Vedas Cool. Today's story is from Sambhava Parva in Adi Parva. In the last video we had seen how Satyavati had summoned her eldest son Vedavyasa for her help. How she had asked Vedavyasa to beget children for the Kuru dynasty. Children or future kings for the almost extinct Kuru dynasty. Now let's see. What happens when this great Rishi Vedavyasa meets the princess of Kosala, the widow of Vichitravirya? Let's read along and find out. Now, the princess of Kosala was waiting in her chamber, thinking of the words that the queen mother told her. She had thoughts of Bhishma or some other elder of the royal family in her mind. And she thought it would be a royal person who was entering her apartment. But then, as the princess was waiting, there entered the great Rishi into her chamber while the lamp was still burning. The princess, the beautiful prince of Kosala, seeing the dark visage, the matted locks, the blazing eyes, the grim beard of this great Rishi, she was so frightened that she closed her eyes in fear. The Rishi, however, wanting to accomplish the words that he gave his mother, went forward. But the princess, even for one second, she did not open her eyes and look at the Rishi. And then, when Vedavyasa came out of the princess's chamber, Satyavati, the queen mother, soon asked her son, "O son, will the princess have an accomplished son now?" Now, hearing this question from his mother, Vedavyasa replied, "Mother, the son of the princess she will bring forth shall be equal in might unto 10,000 elephants. He will be an illustrious royal sage, who will be possessed of great learning and intelligence and energy. Now, this son of the princess will in his time bring forth 100 sons. But from the fault of his mother, he will be born blind." Now, hearing these words from Vedavyasa, Satyavati's hope was completely shattered. She said, "Oh, son, oh, great person of ascetic wealth, how can one blind person become the king of the Kuru dynasty? How can a blind person protect his relatives and family and the subjects of this great dynasty? Please, my son, give us another king, a king worthy of the Kuru dynasty." Now, hearing this request from his mother, Vedavyasa agreed to do as she said, and saying the words, "So be it," Vedavyasa went away. Now, when the time came, the princess of Kosala, Ambika, brought forth an illustrious son, a son who was blind by birth. He was named Dhritarashtra. Now, when the proper time came, Satyavati went and met the second princess, the second wife of late Vichitravirya, Ambalika. And with great difficulty, Satyavati again convinced Ambalika to beget a child from this Rishi. Ambalika, though she had a vision of the Rishi in her mind, yet she was not prepared to what was waiting for her. When Ambalika was waiting in her chamber, the Rishi entered the chamber. And seeing this great sage, who looked terrifying, with his dark visage and his grim beard and his blazing eyes, Ambalika was so frightened that she became pale. She became pale out of fear. Now, seeing this, Vedavyasa addressed her and told Sat thus. He said, "O princess, because you have become pale with fear at my sight, therefore the child that you will get from me will be pale in complexion. Though he will be born a handsome man, he will be so pale that he will be named as Pandu." Saying this, the great Rishi went out of the chamber of the princess Ambalika. He soon met Satyavati, and Satyavati again had the same question. She wanted to know if a worthy king is going to be born for the Kuru dynasty from the union of Ambalika and Vedavyasa. To this, Vedavyasa told her that the son Ambalika would bring forth would be Pandu, would be pale. Though he will be mighty and virtuous, he will be a king who is pale in complexion. Now hearing this, Satyavati was again shattered. She again begged her son to beget another child for the sake of Guru dynasty. Vedavyasa again agreed to his mother's plea, and for now he went away. And when the proper time came, Ambalika brought forth an illustrious son, a son of pale complexion who was named as Pandu. It was this mighty Pandu who fathered the five mighty warriors in Mahabharata, the Pandavas. When the time came, Satyavati again went and met the eldest daughter-in-law of hers, that is Ambika, and again requested her to beget another son, another healthy son from this same Rishi. But this time, Ambika was not ready to listen to her mother-in-law. She refused to do as her mother-in-law said. Remembering the grim visage and strong order of the Rishi, she was already terrified. So what she did this time was, she sent one of her maids, a maid who was as beautiful as an Apsara. She decked up the maid with her own ornaments and clothes and sent the maid to Vedavyasa. Vedavyasa, however, one look at the maid, he came to know everything. But this maid, this Shudra woman, who could look beyond what the Rishi looked like, who could look beyond the looks of the Rishi, saw how great, how illustrious, and how virtuous and knowledgeable the Rishi was. She treated the Rishi with all respects, treated him very well. This great learned Rishi was very pleased with this Shudra woman. And when he was about to leave the chamber, as he rose to go away, he spoke to her. He told her, "O amiable one, you will no longer be a slave. The child that you are going to beget from me will be greatly fortunate and virtuous. He will be the foremost of all intelligent men on earth." And thus, with this blessing from Krishnadvaipayana, the Shudra woman, the maid of Ambika, brought forth an illustrious son who was named Vidura. This son Vidura, who was the god of justice, the Dharma Raja himself born on earth. Now, why is Dharma Raja being born on earth? Was he cursed by somebody? If so, who cursed the great Dharma Raja? Let's read along and find out. Please like, share and subscribe our channel for more Mahabharata stories. Do not forget to press the bell icon. Thank you. Namaste.